Hello and welcome to the Young Author Pod, and today we will learn about the pathological fractures. A fracture is a break in the structural continuity of the bone. Fractures are caused by injury, repetitive stress, or abnormal weakening of the bone. A fracture in an abnormal or diseased bone is referred to as a pathological fracture. A pathological fracture results from a normal force on an abnormal weak bone. The causes of pathological fracture are numerous and varied. The pathology may be localized to one part of the bone, or it may be generalized. The localized causes include chronic infection and tumor deposit. These can be benign tumor, primary malignant tumors, or metastatic tumors. The generalized bone disease include osteoporosis, metabolic bone disease, Paget's disease, and osteogenesis imperfecta. Overall, most common cause is osteoporosis followed by metastasis. Pathological fractures are most common in vertebral bodies of thoracic and lumbar region. The next most common site includes corticocancellous junctions of long bones like proximal femur and lower end of the radius. The X-ray is usually the first investigation and it shows the fracture. The surrounding bone must also be examined, and features such as cyst formation, cortical erosion, and periosteal reaction should be noted. X-rays of the other bones, lungs, and urogenital tract may be necessary to exclude the malignant disease. Other investigations should be done to narrow down the primary pathology and may include blood counts, protein electrophoresis, tests for metabolic disorders, urine examination, radionuclide imaging, and sometimes biopsy. The treatment usually depends on the underlying pathology. A pathological fracture occurring in the setting of a generalized bone disease is usually treated with surgical stabilization and internal fixation. A pathological fracture in a generalized disease usually heal in time. In case of fractures through benign cyst-like lesions, treatment is same as for simple fractures in the same area. When the bone is healed, the tumor can be dealt with curettage or local excision. Pathological fracture in the benign lesion usually heal but take longer time. In case of primary malignant tumor, the fracture may need splinting and internal fixation with load-bearing implants, and also may require excision and endoprosthetic replacement. But definitive treatment of the tumor is the main concern here. The prognosis is almost always very poor. In case of a metastatic tumor, surgical stabilization of the fracture goes hand in hand with the treatment of the primary malignancy. The Mirrell score is used to quantify the risk of impending pathological fracture in a malignant lesion. It is based on four variables: the site of lesion, the size of the lesion, the radiographic appearance of the lesion, and presence and quality of the associated pain. All the variables are assigned progressive scores ranging from 1 to 3. The site of the lesion can be in the upper extremity, lower extremity, or the peritrochanteric area of the femur. The size of the lesion is expressed as a fraction of the bone diameter. The radiographic nature of the lesion is also subdivided into three categories, with progressively increasing scores assigned to plastic, mixed, and lytic lesions. The pain is only subjective variable in this classification system, categorized as mild, moderate, or functional pain. Lesions with score of 7 or lower can be safely irradiated without the risk of fracture, while lesions with scores of 8 or higher require prophylactic internal fixation prior to irradiation. So that's all for now on pathological fractures and Myhrl's score. If you want more such videos, please let us know in the comment section below. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Links are in the description. We will be back with another video in orthopedics. See you soon.